hot out here. No, I don't mind though. I'm just glad to be free. You know what I'm saying?
Mrs. Borges, what can I say? Mrs. Borges was a very interesting woman. She was very kind. She always tried to help people if they needed it, myself included. And I helped in return. She was diagnosed with colon and liver cancer. It's an unfortunate thing to have. Cancer is one of those things that can seem unbeatable, I'd imagine, you know, being that they haven't found a cure or whatnot. And also, it's scary, I'd imagine. It's a scary thing to have. You know, not knowing whether you'll live or die is just, it's terrifying, I'd imagine. But I am very appreciative of her, because without her permission, I wouldn't have got to know Mark Anthony nearly as well as I did, because she allowed me to hang out with him and interact with him and just become friends. And that he's a very close friend of mine, and he's right here now. Mrs. Borges, her personality was an admirable one, because no matter what happened to her, no matter how much pain she was in, she always seemed to keep going. At least the way I saw it. But she She was very strong, because she'd been through a lot in her life, family and etc. She's been through a lot, and it's only fair that she gets to rest. She's had a tough life, but in the end, she gets to rest now. And I remember a couple of good memories with her, where I remember one night, me and Mark, I was hanging out at his house, and it was late. I don't know, it was either 8 or 9, or 9, or going on to 10 o'clock, probably 8 going to 9 o'clock, but I was just hanging out with them. You know, I had eaten dinner with them. You know, she cooked really good. She made really good food. excuse me. She made really good food. She made something with a lot of vegetables and healthy foods, beans, rice. It's delicious. And after that, my mother called me to tell me that, I'm gonna come in to pick you up. And I said, all right. So me and Mark were watching TV. I think we were watching SpongeBob or something. It was either that or, I think it was Madagascar. Something like that. I don't remember entirely. And, you know, we were talking about my channel and how he may want to start a channel. And I was giving him some tips. I was teaching him how to use Bandicam and whatnot. And then my mom came, and her and Mrs. Borges just started talking about, you know, they got to know each other. It was a very nice thing to see. And I, you know, I was just listening to the conversation every once in a while, and I heard her talk about herself. And she's a very admirable person from what I heard. She's been through a lot, and she's toughed through a lot, and I admired her a lot. You know, she seemed happy that day. You know, even if it was just a simple conversation between his mother and my mother, it was a nice memory. You know, me and Mark were playing Five Nights at Freddy's 2, I believe, on his laptop on the floor, after me teaching him how to use Bandicam and how to set up a YouTube channel. And they were talking. We watched something by OniNG. It was nice. And then, another memory is, I believe it was Mark Anthony's birthday. And it was me, Miss Borges, and a couple of our other friends. We got to school before he did. I mean, we got to his house before he did. And we set up a little party for him. And it was nice. We were just talking and, you know, enjoying our days. And all of us, we were just having a good time. It was a nice day. I enjoyed that day, and it seemed like she did too. Even though she may have been in pain, she was happy to see her boy on her birthday, and happy to see him grow. And I remember we were hiding on the other side of the wall that was hidden from the front door to pop out and surprise him with confetti. And then, you know, he came in, we jumped out. I mean, even though we called him and he heard me laughing, but it didn't matter. It was still nice. Jumped out and threw confetti on him. It was funny. And his mother gave him a cake, and we ate pizza, I believe. And it was a nice day. I think that may have been the last time I saw Miss Borges. I'm not sure. And I remember hanging out with Mark Anthony when we used to practice breakdancing. and we went to his basement down under his house, and we break dance and come back and, you know, hang out with his mother.
Jeez.
Nice. And Mark Anthony was blessed to have a mother as good as she was, even if they did fight sometimes. She was a good mother. She did her best to support him as much as she could as a single parent. Who knows? I can't imagine the way Mark Anthony is feeling, but if you are watching this, Mark, I need you to know that you are not alone. And if you need me, I'm just a text message or a phone call away. But stay strong. And rest in peace, Mrs. Borges.